23 years ago, you originated the role of Belle on Broadway in Beauty and the Beast. How did it do? Now, Susan, how do you even prepare to play a strong, smart, and beautiful character like that?
I have a secret weapon, and her name is Linda Wolverton. She is Belle. You can see a picture of her. She is Belle. In fact, she based Gaston on an ex-boyfriend of hers, so certain right. So I had this smart, brilliant, funny, lovely woman right there, and I could ask her all the questions in the world.
Oh, what a gift that is. You know, we have some fun slides, and can you take us through the making of Belle and your story, right? Let's see what we got here, right? So, oh, look at that.
I remember the dress that came out with the logo. The logo was the silhouette of Belle and the Beast waltzing, and then we got that sort of mask that was very sort of phantom-esque, you know? It was Disney going Broadway. Pretty cool. They made these t-shirts in New York because a lot of children came to the theater for the first time and said, my first Broadway show, but they only made them in children's sizes, except they made one for me in my size.
Ooh. Now what were you thinking here?
Oh my goodness. Funny faces to the girls behind. And I know this is Disney, but I think I'm going to go ahead and say it. When we first saw these costumes, I could literally ask them, what's your cup size?
Nice. Let's see what other slides we have.
That's Paige. Oh, Tom Bosley. Okay. Tom Bosley was the heart of this whole show. Of course, he was Mr. Cunningham on Happy Days. We all knew him. But few people knew that he had won a Tony Award as the title character of Fiorello on Broadway. And so this was him coming back to Broadway after many years. He played Maurice, he was incredible. And we used to joke that Belle's last name was Cunningham. And this is Terry. So this picture was taken, that one over there, was taken about 6 months before we started rehearsals. So unlike every other Broadway producer, Disney knew how they wanted to market. And so I had seen Terry at the audition. Terrence Mann played the Beast, sorry. And then they took us over to Brooklyn for this photo shoot and a commercial shoot. And they had to quickly make that costume for him and that costume for me. But that's the last time we ever wore those specific costumes. It was just for the commercial shoot. And so it was like, okay, now be in love. And we're going to take a picture. And that ended up being the poster. Crazy. Here we are. This is all of us. This is the LA company. I can tell because that's Ivy and that's Jeff Schechter. And it's a different cast. And this, at the end, they would all smile and hold, and we were just trying to catch our breath. It was a 12-minute number that took two 12-hour days to tech, to get through Be Our Guest one time when we were teching the show. I hate this picture. So, see, had I seen this one beforehand, I never would have approved that. But that was from that very first photo shoot. Like, we hadn't figured out the wig yet, we hadn't figured out the dress, I'm not even in character. Next.
Okay, what a ride this has been for you. We're so grateful to have you here today. Now, D23 fans, I mean, Susan's here, right? And since she's an amazing singer and performer, and she can originate the role of Belle on Broadway, right? Maybe, just maybe she'd be open to performing for us?
Than a fairy tale dream come true. Ellen. I'm still cheating. I'm still seeing all of her music. But let's face it, I'm now the age of Mrs. Potts. Of course, her song, well, it won the Academy Award. Here's a little movie of what it was like behind the scenes doing this play so long ago. Look, I have the same haircut, but I was a lot younger. To say the